Get ready to spend the next 2 hours with our three sports-loving ladies, Mia O'Brien, Lauren Brooks, and Taylor Dahl.
This is Helmets and Heels
on 1010XL, switched on by First Coast Lighting and Fans. Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor. Show me what you got, pretty
lady. Welcome into a Wednesday edition of Helmets and Heels. It is a beautiful day here on the First Coast, and we are with you until 2 p.m. Mia O'Brien, yesterday we had this awful job of having to be on air while Trevor Lawrence and Foye Luikin met with the media.
We did get Foye one-on-one.
We did
a week
get Foye
2 weeks earlier, the official basketball analyst of 1010XL. So that's why I said, you know what? It's okay. Everyone else can have their moment to speak with our very own, our friend of the program of Helmets and Heels.
That's true. He is a friend of the program. And, of course, Trevor Lawrence, we would love for him to come in studio whenever he so desires. And he can break down anything that he wants, whether that ranges from his golf game to anything. But certainly got to hear from both of those guys. And I think this time of year is when everybody is on the same page. Everybody is excited to be back. It's, of course, months from now when the losses are piling up. Hopefully that doesn't happen around here. But it's at those times that things start to get a little bit more difficult as far as meeting with media is concerned. But we talked about it yesterday, the fact, Taylor, that Trevor said he wasn't healthy really until March. And so I think at this point now that we're just really a month removed from that, He's probably like, okay, I've got some work to do to make sure that my body is in even better shape than a year ago when I entered the season.
Yeah, and I'm sure with Trevor, you know that, and we talked about it a tad yesterday, that Trevor does have that he has not used to losing. He didn't lose a lot when he was in high school or college, and then he came to the Jags and things changed a bit in that aspect, and he obviously does not like that. And so last year when he was banged up, he wanted to push through a lot of things that maybe he shouldn't have, that if he would have been able to take a week or two off without having to push himself, maybe it wouldn't have lingered into March. But I think also it points to just such a factor of what a lot of us were screaming back in January, February of don't put the same offensive line that got your quarterback hurt until March back on the football field. And, you know, they added now Mitch Morse. That's like the piece that they've kind of added. Aside from that, it's all looks like they'll be returning. So I think that's a big question mark, too. And you'd hope that some of these guys will take even that next step up. And Mitch, being the center anchor piece, will kind of bring everything together, because you don't want another scenario next year where Trevor's getting banged up constantly week after week.
Yeah, the offensive line has to play a lot better for this team to get where they want to go. And I think, Mia, at this point, it's nice that they've had several months to be able to decompress. Because Trevor even said yesterday, you know, I know at the end of the season I said some negative stuff, and I've had some time to reflect on that. And I'm sure when you're the quarterback in your first year, everything goes to hell in a handbasket. Your second year, you make the playoffs. Everything's great. And then this past year, you play through some of the worst injuries you've ever experienced in your career, and you still don't make the postseason. You are going to be really frustrated at that point in time.
Yeah, I think that was the headline. If you missed the press conference yesterday, the headline coming out was that Trevor Lawrence said, and we actually, why am I describing this, Lauren? Don't we have the soundbite in front of us? RJ, could you please play for us yesterday's, in my opinion, the bottom line from Trevor Lawrence and his first availability of the 2024 season?
It took a while. I mean, I'd probably say March. You know, when March hit, I felt really good, like lifting and doing everything like totally normal. You know, I'd been so used to the back half of the season adjusting everything, whether it was workout or throwing or practice or whatever it was. You know, I gave myself, I would work out but still modified. But until March, I'd say that's when I started to feel like 100% do the stuff that I normally do and can kind of get back in the kind of shape I want to be and train the way I wanted to. So yeah, it took a little while.
Which, that's why he was on all his vacations.
Right, because he couldn't train in full, and he probably, you know, mentally, emotionally needed a bit of a break from football, because, you know, sometimes distance makes the heart grow fonder, and perhaps that was part of it. I do think that in addition to the obvious, like I said, bottom line of his health being a question up and until a month ago, the other big takeaway were the questions surrounding where the offense is headed. And that's when I say distance makes the heart grow fonder in terms of wanting to get back to the grind and like and missing that grind, like he alluded to, that he hasn't been able to fully participate in because he was recovering from all those injuries, because they wanted to make sure he was at full strength. The other part of it, too, is the idea of how has the offense been reworked versus where the offense was left in shambles in early January, putting it to the side, getting away from it, fresh set of eyes coming back to it. And so, yes, on the text line, Design My Lifetime Enclosures from Kansas. Thank you, 620. T-Law mentioned necessary changes we've made already on offense. To my knowledge, we've only upgraded at center. Gabe Davis is probably at best a wash with Ridley leaving. Not so sure I agree on that part, but to your point about necessary changes already made on offense, I would think, and again, I do not have the playbook in front of me, but from what I've been told and what I've gathered, those necessary changes are the framework of the offense, the simplification of an offense that many players said last year, for some, was too complicated. And so is this Press Taylor taking a look in the mirror? Is this Doug Peterson becoming more involved because perhaps he doesn't have to, quote-unquote, babysit the defense like he did last season, especially in the final month and a half? I'm not sure.
Is it Trevor saying, hold on, stop everything, stop the presses, I need to have more influence because, as he said yesterday, I'm the one actually pulling the trigger. Like, I'm the quarterback who's either going to make the great throws or make the mistakes.
It could be that, too.
That's what I hope that it's a combination of all three of those.
Yes, but that's when he says the necessary changes were made already on offense. I came away from it as, personally speaking, and I know he wouldn't commit to this, even if Press Taylor is running the plays in 2024, it is an offense that was designed by Doug Peterson, who ultimately will have final say. And I know there are those who will say he had ultimate say last year. He could have vetoed things that Press Taylor did. He was trying to let Press Taylor learn on the job. That's great. For me, 2022, when Press only called the second half plays, it was an offense designed by Doug. And he did a pretty good job. So maybe he can call plays, but the actual offense needs to be designed by one of the top play callers in the National Football League. Otherwise, as Doug said at the Combine, Taylor, perhaps it is a detriment to the organization if he's not fully utilizing his skill set and what he was hired for.
Yeah, and I think when it goes back to that statement, to me, it is an interesting, it's an interesting way to say it, because I do think there's still things that need to be done offensively, personally. I don't think it's, okay, we're good. If the season started next month, I would not be comfortable with what everything looks like right now. And especially because it has been so wishy-washy of what's going on with Press and with Doug. I think that when you had one of, if not the worst run games in the league last season, and some of that did go around the offensive line. Some of that did go around play calling. Maybe you do need another back that you can trust. I know a lot of people want to give Tank another try and say, hey, you know, maybe year two, there's a step there. But there were critical turnover situations in that. So that's a question mark there. I Gabe Davis, and I've mentioned this a lot, Gabe Davis and Calvin Ridley are very different wide receivers. I still think there needs to be another weapon in the room. And obviously, you just want to see everything. Also, we saw last year, sometimes it takes a little time for certain quarterbacks and wide receivers to really start clicking and figuring things out. How long will that take for Gabe and Trevor? We don't know. We'll find out pretty quickly. Just like we kind of did with Calvin last year, even though Calvin never got to quite the page we wanted him to be on, you'd hope Gabe will get that a little bit quicker when it comes to the playbook, because he has not missed a couple years of football. But I do think there's still moves to be made. But I get what Trevor's saying of, like, hey, we've started these. To me, like, we've started these initial steps of fixing the offensive and the places that we knew it needed to be fixed. And that's play calling. That's the run game. That's situational football. He knows himself. And that's something that him and Doug now have spoke on about Trevor himself. And that's something that now looks like it's going to be a focus this offseason.
Yes, absolutely. We will continue our discussion on Trevor Lawrence and hear a little bit more of his comments from yesterday as we continue to talk Jaguars leading up to the draft. But we also have to continue our countdown to the draft. We head from Florida to Minnesota to talk with Tyler Fornes.
Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
Ready? In 3, 2, 1.
The countdown to the draft is on.
I hope you're ready.
Who'll be off the board when the Jaguars pick? Let's find out.
All right, we are joined now by Tyler Fornes. He covers Vikings football for Sporting News and Score North. Tyler, thank you so much for hopping on with us. I know it was a kind of a pinch hit situation for you, so I really appreciate it.
My pleasure, Taylor. Glad to be on.
So let's get right to this. We're doing this countdown to kind of give us an idea of who could still be on the board when the Jaguars pick at 17. All sorts of ways we can go with this, and I know a lot of the speculation seems like the Vikings would like to trade up for a quarterback. That's a lot of the things that we're hearing. Kirk Cousins heading to Atlanta, and so that definitely leaves a hole there, even with an addition of Sam Darnold. But before we get to that, Tyler, let's start with that departure of Kirk and the feelings in Minnesota surrounding that move and where that kind of leaves the quarterback room now.
I think the biggest thing with the Kirk Cousins departure is everybody kind of knew it was coming. He was brought in 2018 essentially as a mercenary, where the team felt that they just needed a quarterback to be able to take them over the hump. The feeling was that was going to be Teddy Bridgewater, and then he suffered that devastating knee injury in 2016. And Rick Spielman, as you can kind of tell from some of his pre-draft comments, did not want to be aggressive in moving up to go get a quarterback because he failed spectacularly with the Christian Ponder pick. And then the Teddy Bridgewater pick didn't work out. So he went a different way and ended up going to the free agent route, getting Kirk Cousins. And the mood was incredibly happy, but it never worked out. And it wasn't that Kirk Cousins was bad. He was brought in to do a job. He did not get that job done. It left some animosity amongst half the fan base. The other half essentially praised him like the almighty. But once he left, it was just kind of a level of acceptance and quickly move forward, because within a couple days, the Vikings traded to get 23rd overall, and all the focus shifted towards the NFL draft and being able to get that guy. Kirk Cousins feels like a distant memory at this point, and I think for this fan base, it's a good thing.
With all that said, let's cut to the chase, Tyler. Are the Minnesota Vikings trading into the top five, specifically for J.J. McCarthy in the NFL draft?
I have no lean on what the Vikings are going to want to do as far as which quarterback they're going to prefer. Obviously, when you look at stylistically, McCarthy makes a lot of sense. So does Drake May. But then there were also heavy, heavy rumors right before the draft that the Minnesota Vikings had done a lot of work on Anthony Richardson and made some aggressive offers to go and get him in this 2023 draft. Those didn't come to fruition for multiple reasons, but we don't really know who they want. We can project, we can think, but Kwesi Adofo-Mensah said in his pre-draft press conference that they have multiple quarterbacks they love, and they are going to kind of take that style of approach where they're not going to pencil themselves into one specific instance. They're not going to be like, it's this or nothing. Kwesi Adofo-Mensah's from Wall Street. You hedge and diversify consistently in the financial world, and I think he's going to use that in his planning to try and figure out how to attack the quarterback position. I think there's probably around a 40% chance ends up being McCarthy. I also wouldn't be shocked if McCarthy goes two. Those picks 2 through 5 are going to be such a fascinating watch come draft day, because who knows, maybe Drake May has that Justin Fields ball and the Vikings end up getting him at 11 or on a shorter trade up. But there really is a huge mystery around what quarterback the Vikings want. And it could be Michael Penix Jr. We genuinely don't know. Everybody is just trying to project based on watching the film, looking at the analytics and the style of offense. And let's just be real. McCarthy does make a lot of sense, but nobody really knows.
If it was up to you, who would you select with the 11th pick?
I would. If he was there, I would take Drake May, and I wouldn't think twice. I would also, quote-unquote, mortgage the future to go get him. I think he's special. He has a lot of footwork, mechanical stuff that you have to work on with him, but he does the special thing. And when you kind of look at what Josh Allen was coming out of college, he didn't know how to play quarterback, but he could just do these special things with movement and throwing the ball down the field with pinpoint accuracy on the move. And if you can teach him some of those things, you can get a high-end player. And I think May kind of fits that archetype. He's not a one-to-one comparison, but I think it makes sense. And if all four quarterbacks are gone, that's when things get really murky. Because do you believe in Michael Penix Jr. enough to make him the 11th overall pick? Do you wait until 23 to be able to take that quarterback? Because you have no day two capital to trade with this year. And you have no second round pick in 25 to move up with either. If there's no quarterback available, I would consider Alabama corner Terrion Arnold or Penn State edge Chop Robinson. I think I'm the highest in the industry on Chop Robinson. He's my fourth overall player. But he has the first step off the ball like Von Miller. And you can't teach that. It's incredibly special. And I genuinely think that he could make a massive, massive impact on the Vikings right away and down the line. But then you still have that hole at quarterback. So how the Vikings end up approaching things is going to be really fascinating, but expect a premium position, and if it's not quarterback, I lean towards the defense heavily.
Quick related side tangent, Tyler. Tyler Fornes of Score North and Sporting News joining us on the the All-Pro Roofing phone line. Jaden Daniels, Drake May, and J.J. McCarthy all went on a joint visit to the Commanders yesterday. How do you think that dynamic played out? or did they do a pool party? Did they play Top Golf? It's fascinating, like, which character in a buddy cop sitcom each of those guys are.
I thought that was a really fascinating idea. Well, first off, Top Golf apparently is half price golf on Tuesdays, so you know the Commanders got a heck of a deal bringing all their visits there. But I really thought it was interesting. One thing the Vikings did under Rick Spielman was they did all their top 30 visits on one day. And with the top 30 visit, you can't put them through a workout. You basically can interview them, tour the facility with them, and do medical stuff. So you're getting information, but you're not getting anything related to on the field. So the idea of bringing in all these guys at once is you get to get them relaxed, get them in a comfortable environment, and then you get to really judge a little bit on who they are with interaction, how they handle pressure, how they handle chaos, how they handle different situations. How do they talk to the kitchen and janitorial staff? All of those things will end up mattering once they get in the building, but in order to find out how they handle those situations, you have to get them in the building. So I find that really interesting, and then you can see how the quarterback prospects talk amongst themselves because they know they're fighting over millions of dollars here. Mm-hmm. They're not just, hey, who's going to start at quarterback on the playground in fifth grade? No. If McCarthy goes at 2 and May goes at 11, that's a difference of like $10 million. That's very, very significant. So I think it's really interesting, but the buddy cop sitcom, I would love to see. And you know it's going to star Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly.
I love it. Tyler, another big conversation coming up there in Minnesota is Justin Jefferson. A contract talks coming along. Do you see Vikings committing? Because we're kind of seeing this era now where some guys are getting paid, but some teams are realizing they can snag a guy in the draft and not have to pay big dollars. And I will say, too, if you want to pass Justin Jefferson down here to Jacksonville, we will take him.
Well, you have Gabe Davis. You're just fine. But I actually wrote about this for a thesis on Substack Wide Left a couple days ago because the wide receiver market has been shifting. Ever since the salary cap has gone up, it was going up before the pandemic around $10 million a year, but it's gone up $72.9 million since 2021. That's an average of $24.3 million per season. Because of that, we're seeing wide receivers sign significantly less contracts. And these contracts are averaging 3 years. So your DK Metcalf, Terry McLaurin, they signed three-year deals in 2022. They are now ready to sign their next contract, and they're not even 30 yet. Mm-hmm. And I think that approach is going to be something we're going to see more and more from wide receivers. And we're also going to see it from NFL teams because there's such a plethora of wide receivers coming out in the draft. 7-on-7 camps are making these guys better much earlier, and therefore you're able to get the value for a rookie contract. But the big thing with Jefferson is he missed voluntary workouts last year. He did a bunch of promotional stuff, and they were – this close to signing a contract extension last September. It feels like they're just dotting the T's, cross the I's. To me, it's a nothing burger. I think they're going to commit to him. They want to commit to him. The Vikings front office has been very laissez-faire about talking about a lot of things. They were very direct and confident when talking about Justin Jefferson, and to me, that speaks a lot of volumes. It's not like Rick Spielman said, we're not trading Percy Harvin and we're not trading Stephon Diggs, and then he goes and does those things. Kwesi is a much different style of speaker and communicator, and I don't see a scenario unless Justin Jefferson goes to the front office and say, I want to be traded, where he ends up not being a member of the Minnesota Vikings long term.
Yeah, when you look at that list next year that are Stephon Diggs, T. Higgins, Keenan Allen, Chris Godwin, Justin Jefferson, Mike Williams, Amari Cooper, Brandon Ayuk, that is just a few of the wide receiver names that are becoming free agents in 2025. So a lot of contracts to talk about in the NFL there.
Yeah, absolutely. And what's fascinating about that list is you're probably going to see 1 to 3 of them hit free agency because most of them are going to end up re-upping because we know how important wide receivers are, especially when it comes to developing and nurturing a young quarterback, which is another big reason I don't see the Vikings even trying to move on from Jefferson.
Tyler Fornes, our guest on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline, as we wrap up with you. And before I ask you, Tyler, to promote everywhere we can find your content, I do want to circle back to the point you made, how if it is not a quarterback for the Minnesota Vikings in this month's NFL draft, you could see an edge rusher or a corner like Terrion Arnold being the pick at 11. How much of that is Brian Flores really digging in his heels and saying, I need to get more of my guys in here versus replenishing perhaps what they lost with Danielle Hunter signing with the Houston Texans?
I think the prioritizing Jonathan Greenard over Danielle Hunter was already the start of that. And the biggest thing is Hunter's a better player, and very few people are going to even try to have the conversation that Greenard is better. But Greenard is better in two areas. He's got incredible arm length, 92nd percentile arms. I think they're 35 and an eighth inch. And then he has a very, very quick get off on the football, something Danielle Hunter did not have. Hunter was a great pass rusher, and he could beat you multiple ways, but he was much more of a technician than he was really explosive off the ball. And with how Brian Flores loves to prioritize the blitz, you've got to be quick off the ball and get that pressure really fast, because the time to throw is going to be significantly lower than you would just with the standard four-man rush. I think his influence is already being felt, but we also saw with last year's defense, he decided to roll with three safeties and do something completely different, borrowing from the Pitt Panthers 2021 defense by using a shell coverage with an all-out blitz package. So I think he's going to try and prioritize specific players and then adapt with them. But I also don't see a situation where Flores is like, I need this guy or my defense can't run, because he made it work with a subpar roster last year and made them an average team.
All right, Tyler. So if you are a betting man, is Sam Darnold the quarterback week one, and then you get one of those guys you talked about at 11? Or is it a different quarterback and Sam Darnold's a backup?
I think week one, I would put like minus 500 odds Sam Darnold's the starting quarterback, because I don't think they're going to rush whoever they end up picking to be that starter. I just think they want to make sure that they're 100% comfortable and ready to go, because as important as talent is, the mental makeup of quarterbacks is really important. You don't want to hurt their confidence, and you want to make sure that they're in a great spot. A guy like Peyton Manning thrived by setting NFL record for interceptions, and he was just fine. Ryan Leaf, his counterpart, absolutely tanked. So it all depends on the player. So I think they're going to take it much more careful, because it's a long play, not a short-term one.
All right, Tyler, before we let you go, where can folks find your work?
Absolutely. You can find me on Twitter at TheRealForno. I cover the Vikings for the Sporting News, and I also cover them for Score North, where we have an NFL draft show, Purple Daily on Draft, and my YouTube channel, Vikings First and Skull. We're also on all podcast feeds. We try to take a different approach talking to the Minnesota Vikings than your standard beat writers. We talk about it from an NFL draft perspective. We're blunt and honest, and we have a good time doing it.
And you also talk a little AEW, so I am sure the AEW fans out there will be checking out at The Real Forno on X. Thanks so much for joining us, Tyler.
My pleasure. You two have a great day.
Yeah, he's got his whole link tree with all the links and everything that he's doing in the NFL and Viking space, so make sure you guys check that out. Let's stay with some draft talk.
That's
Lauren.
Right. Yeah, Roger Hoover's going to join us next. Of course, he was the Jumbo Shrimp announcer here, but then moved back to Alabama, where he's from. He's the broadcaster and host on the Crimson Tide Sports Network, so we will talk with him about the Alabama prospects as we continue that series right here on Helmets and Heels on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
Get Florida Gators play-by-play on 1010XL.
The Gators hope for harmony in Music City, Florida Vanderbilt, Thursday and Friday night and Saturday afternoon on 1010 AM.
The Jacksonville Orthopedic Institute is now offering online scheduling for new patient appointments for all of their positions. Simply schedule your appointment on your cell phone, tablet, or desktop. JOI is the first orthopedic practice in North Florida to offer this feature to patients. To schedule your appointment online, visit joi.net and click on the button at the top of the page. If you'll be using insurance, be sure and have your information handy. JOI, where the pros go.
Now that's what I call high-quality H2O.
If you want high-quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. Water Boy JAX, Beards.com.
It's back. The biggest jewelry sale of the year. Buy one, get one at Beards Diamonds.
No other jewelry store in North Florida can match it. Buy any band and get the other one free.
The whole month of April.
Beards Diamonds will beat any competitor's price.
At the St. John's Town Center.
This is Joe C. from XL Primetime and stoked to crank up the 9 after 5 once again at the Golf Club of Southampton. Every Wednesday, a little after 5, the gang at Southampton will be hosting us with a new game, and I'm inviting you to be a part of it. Now through the summer stretch, break up the week with a little hump day fun every Wednesday. Call 287-PLAY to get on the tee sheet. There'll be food afterwards and prizes, including playing for a membership at the Golf Club of Southampton. Call 287-PLAY and hit the tee with Joe C.
Men, suffering from erectile dysfunction or PE? Frustrated taking pills that don't work? Here's a message from Prime Men's Medical Center.
I'm Dr. Simovitz. Prime Men's Medical Center offers breakthrough treatments with men lasting longer than ever without pain or surgery.
Call now. Your consultation and first treatment are free. You'll see instant results right in the office. Call Prime Men's Medical Center now. 904-664-8217. That's 904-664-8217.
What's the weekend in sports look like? I'm Dan Hicken, and I'll give you my take on The Weekend with Dan. Find it on YouTube and Facebook. Weekend with Dan, brought to you by Stone Core. We do outdoors better.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you. Proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Dave Binion here with my son Ammon, who is the air duct cleaning manager at Zero Res. So Ammon, you may notice a little rattle in my voice and some puffiness in my eyes. That's because allergy season is coming on. Can Zero Res help?
Yes. Your health has a lot to do with the air you breathe. A clean and healthy home begins with clean air. At Zero Res, we can help clean the air in your home by cleaning your air ducts, cleaning the coils in your HVAC units, and fogging the system with a powerful antimicrobial that helps kill and control the growth of microorganisms in your air. We also have options for maintaining your clean air with our excellent inline air purifier and UV lights that will help keep your system clean and healthy. At Zero Res, we are more than just air duct cleaners. We're a clean air specialist.
Have Zero Res air duct specialists out, and right now we'll give you $50 off your air duct cleaning, and while we're at it, we'll give you $50 off your dryer vent cleaning. Zero Res.
Spelled forward or backwards, it's the right way to clean.
Z-E-R-O-R-E-Z. Zero Res. This is Hayes Carline for SkyLife Elite. Are you tired of canceled flights, unruly passengers, and layovers? Call my friends at SkyLife Elite. Consider using private charter flights for your next adventure. Yes, you can afford it. Make your own schedule. Fly direct. Drive your car to Craig Airport and get directly on the plane. SkyLife Elite can make that happen. Call 490-9332, go to flyskylife.com, and find them on social media. Fly SkyLife Elite, North Florida's premier private air charter.
Lauren Brooks here for Hodges Mazda. Why buy from Hodges Mazda at the Avenues? Because they strive to ensure a satisfying and comfortable car buying experience. That's why the sales staff doesn't work on commission, allowing Hodges Mazda to put your best interest first. Whether you're looking for a brand new Mazda or a pre-owned vehicle, Hodges Mazda has a large selection to help you choose from. And every vehicle purchase from Hodges Mazda comes with 2 years free maintenance and free car washes for life. Now that is peace of mind. So visit Hodges Mazda today or shop online at HodgesMazda.com.
Let's go! Looking for a night of action without a big hit to your bankroll? This Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena, cheer on your Sharks as they go all in against the Las Vegas Nighthawks. See what I did there? With tickets as low as $15, you can't find this kind of family affordable fun anywhere else. Call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. Let's go! Decades night. Find that old members-only jacket or favorite flannel shirt. We're celebrating the 90s. What's your favorite decade?
Let's go!
Don't miss the fun this Saturday, April 20th at 7 o'clock in the Vistar Veterans Memorial Arena. For tickets, call 904-621-0700 or visit jacksharks.com. That's tickets at 904-621-0700.
Let's go! Let's go!
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line.
This is Helmets and Heels.
Kept classy by First Coast Lighting and Fans. Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor.
On 1010XL.
You just heard Tyler Fornes of Sporting News on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline say if the Minnesota Vikings don't go quarterback, he thinks Terrion Arnold of Alabama would be a great fit for them at number 11. Who better to ask about the Alabama cornerbacks, all the Alabama prospects entering this year's NFL draft, than our old buddy, a Luke Combs fan as well, so perfect timing with a little Where the Wild Things Are, RJ. It's Roger Hoover, now with the Alabama Radio Network. How are you, my friend?
Hey, good to talk to you again, my friend. Yeah, I feel like out where the wild things are, that can describe a Jacksonville my 20s, as the voice of the Jacksonville Suns, Jumbo Shrimp. It was a great time. I miss all of you on the First Coast, but thrilled to reconnect and talk about some really good football players that could be a good fit for the Jacks.
We will always have Gauchos. Or what's the one? Yes, that's the one we went to, I believe, your swan song downtown, Roger.
Absolutely.
Dos Gatos.
Wow. Dos Gatos, yeah.
Dos Gatos. I butchered that one. I knew I butchered it. The one class didn't matter, elementary, middle school, high school. I'm not very good at foreign languages. Let's leave it at that. Roger, again, now works for the University of Alabama's Crimson Tide Sports Network, of course, covering baseball, which is part of why we had to shift our schedule a little bit, because you've been doing such a great job covering baseball, which naturally gets rained out from time to time in the spring months, but also covering the University of Alabama football team. We'll ask you about where that program currently is, but again, let's start with those prospects. Terrion Arnold, Kool-Aid McKinstry. What makes each of those two players unique? How are they different?
I think what makes them unique is the different paths they took to start him as cornerback for Alabama. Starting with Terrion Arnold, he came out of high school in Tallahassee as a safety and eventually transitioned into being a great lockdown corner for Alabama, whereas Kool-Aid McKinstry was kind of able to step into that role pretty early in his Alabama career as a sophomore, got the starting spot, and kind of had the kind of career that everyone expected him to have, being a local in-state product here in the state of Alabama. I mean, he was a household name for his high school football accolades. So for Terrion Arnold, he was more of an unknown, and he was somebody that kind of grew through some tough times, most notably the loss that Alabama had against Tennessee in 2022. At times, he had some tough moments in that ball game, but he kept playing well afterwards, and he kept earning the respect of the coaching staff, and he had a tremendous season for the Crimson Tide this past year, leading the way in interceptions, one of the best tacklers on the team. He was just always around the football, and it wasn't just against the wide receivers he was going up against, or even, you know, some great tight ends in the SEC. He had some good tackles against them, and he was good at, you know, rushing the quarterback or stopping a run game as well. So I was always really impressed with Terrion from that standpoint, the way he got so good by the time his 3 years in Tuscaloosa came to a close. And also the fact that it seems like there was no player on this Alabama roster that got closer to Miss Terry, Nick Saban's wife, than Terrion Arnold through the years. I mean, he just really became a favorite of the Saban family in a way that really none of us had really seen covering Alabama football in the last 17 years. So Terrion Arnold, a great personality. He great success, again, the way he was highly touted coming out of high school, but after some tough moments early in his career, really grew as time went on to being one of the best defenders in the nation. Again, Kool-Aid McKinstry, just an athlete. He was such a good football player in high school, as I mentioned, here locally in Alabama. Everybody knew about him coming into Alabama, and he was a great punt returner. He had the great athleticism there really all throughout his time. He was a dynamic player on special teams, in addition to being somebody that teams did not want to throw towards, so that allowed Terrion Arnold on the other end of the field to get a lot more opportunities to shine, and that's why Alabama was so good, shutting down some really good passing attacks in the SEC this past year, notably shutting down Georgia, a team that no one else had been able to shut down in college football over the last few years. Alabama played its best game really thanks to those two guys alone, Terrion Arnold and Kool-Aid McKinstry, with what they're able to do defensively, slowing down Carson Beck, allowing Alabama to win one final SEC championship for Coach Saban.
Roger, back-to-back days for me talking to you about Alabama football and some of these players. But when it comes to Arnold, you talked about that leap, and not only in production during those 3 years, but obviously playing time. In 2021, he didn't see any at all. Seven starts the next season, and then We just saw what he was able to do in 2023. And it kind of is the way of the world in Alabama, playing that waiting game, waiting your turn. But when it is your turn, showing off. And it seems like that's what he was able to do. But tell us a little bit about the character of the guys who do wait when it, you know, sometimes it's 2-3 years for them to have their turn, and specifically Arnold.
Yeah, he is just another success story of somebody that did wait his time. And I think at the transfer portal age, it's going to become much fewer and far between to have stories like Terron Arnold, someone that's able to stay patient, kind of get that opportunity to shine. And then usually it's a dynamic junior year like Terron obviously had. But we've seen this time and time again with Crimson Tide players on both offense and defense through the years. Really, Derrick Henry didn't even get some of the bulk of his carries until his final year at Alabama, and that ultimately led to him winning the Heisman Trophy. It's just part of the system that Coach Saban put in many, many years ago, that you're going to have a lot of competition, you're going to have a lot of tough players to beat out playing time, but we will stick with you and give you the chance to get better. And Terron did that, and again, he did it with really great personality and just seemed to be such a fit for the Nick Saban process. And I mentioned the relationship he had off the field with the Saban family to the point where they really, again, treat him like one of their own. And that is not something we saw too often in Tuscaloosa. You know, he finishes up his pro day in Tuscaloosa a few weeks ago, and Nick Saban's daughter Kristen is there to have a FaceTime with Miss Terry for Terron to talk to her right after he was done with his workout in front of NFL scouts and executives. So I think that's a good glimpse, and again, how special he was around this campus.
Well, maybe a podcast, Roger, Terron and Terry, I think, or just Terry and Terry. I think that would go well.
I like that. Yeah, that's a really good idea. That'd be good on Simpson XL.
Absolutely. We'll welcome Miss Terry with Okanagan.
But he's a Jaguar. We'll get it going.
Exactly. Now that they're going to be in Florida, of course. All right, so let's look at a guy who I don't think will be there when the Jaguars pick 17th. But if, for some reason, Edge Dallas Turner fell, any chance that – or not any chance, obviously, I think the Jaguars would be interested. But do you think he would play well on this team?
Yeah, absolutely. I think he's going to be a fit no matter which organization he goes to, because he's just got athleticism that you can't coach. And he was able to make an impact right away as a freshman. And, you know, he was really taking a lot of pressure away from Will Anderson Jr., who everybody was trying to game plan against. But all of a sudden, teams had Dallas Turner on the other side of the line coming in as an edge rusher. And it became just a really three-headed monster as time went on, along with a guy named Chris Braswell, who I think is going to be a very productive NFL player in the future as well. When those three were on the field, they called it the cheetah package, because they were all just so fast in getting to the quarterback. So Dallas Turner off the field, a great leader for this football team, more of a quiet leader, I would say, than guys like Kool-Aid McKinstry or Terron Arnold, but certainly somebody that commanded respect with his work ethic. There was not a harder worker. And when it came to the weight room, the film room, the study he did was just incredible on opposing quarterbacks in the SEC. And he was just a winning player. He's another shining example of what a Saban-era player at Alabama should be. And I think he'll fit in very well to any NFL organization that drafts him.
A couple more for Roger Hoover on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. I'm glad you brought up Braswell, because I do want to ask you, Roger, about some of these day two, day three picks from the University of Alabama. Braswell, of course, being at the top of that list of that second wave. Do you believe he's an outside linebacker, a stand-up rush guy? Is he more of a true big end? How would you describe his play and maybe where his draft stock could eventually land up next week?
Yeah, he's really interesting because I think he can fit a lot of those different roles you mentioned. You know, he's 6'3", 255 pounds, and he's just kind of built different. Just the size and the width that he has, especially in the shoulders. I mean, he is a physically imposing player, and he was very malleable in his time at Alabama, used in a lot of different directions. And he's another player that his playing time kind of increased as time went on. But, I mean, he would rotate in a lot even as an underclassman, and you would look down the stat sheet at the end of the game and maybe you wouldn't always remember some of these plays, but all of a sudden you're like, oh, Chris Braswell also had 5 tackles. He had 2 tackles for a loss. Kind of where'd that come from? He was just always around the football and just always had great speed to go along with really impressive size. So, again, I'm no football expert, but I think he is going to be somebody that's going to be around this game a very long time in the NFL, because he can fill so many roles. And one thing I should mention about all these different players, all these guys cut their teeth on special teams playing for Alabama, because Coach Saban always stressed the importance of getting special teams reps for his players that he wanted to have long NFL careers. And one of the ways you can stay on an NFL roster is being sure you are able to be a solid contributor on special teams. Chris Braswell fit into that mold very well on both punt return duties or punt blocking assignments, trying to block field goals. He was always on the field when it mattered the most.
Roger, another name that looks like another first-round player coming out of Alabama. We can just add them all up. But J.C. Latham, it seems like the Chargers really like them. They have their eye on him, a possible trade back to get Latham. But tell us a little bit about him and his role on that offensive line last season.
Really good signs, really calmed down the right side of the line where the left side had a little bit of inconsistency. Caden Proctor had a decent freshman year, but at times the speed of the game would get a little too much for him. JC kind of had the size to go along with some quick footwork that allowed him to be able to maintain his blocks. And again, he's a very physical player, just a huge, large chest, takes up a lot of room in whatever room he's in, and especially blocking edge rushers. He was really, really good for Alabama. And you talk about another fun personality. I mean, he is very outspoken on social media. He had a large chain that he wore to SEC Media Days with his nickname on it that kind of ties into his social media handles. I mean, this is a guy that kind of gets the content game to go along with his play on the field. So he'd be a fan favorite anywhere he ends up.
I want to get to one last question draft-wise, Roger, before we do ask you about Kalen DeBoer, what you saw in the Alabama spring game, his first as the leader of the Crimson Tide. I wanted this final draft question to be about Will Reichert and the kicker, but I will save our Helmets and Heels audience, which we are now calling them Heeligans, by the way. I will spare them the kicker talk because Joe on our YouTube chat line did want your take on these reports about the character of Jermaine Burton, the former Georgia-turned-Alabama wide receiver that has been questioned by different draft analysts. What do you make of that chatter? Is it just his personality that maybe a bit off-putting, and maybe how this will affect him on draft day?
Well, he's certainly one of the most emotional players that we've had in the last few years of the Saban era. I mean, he would get very, very hyped up in game. Specifically, I think you look back to the Texas A&M game. I can't remember if he had a penalty or not for excessive celebration or unsportsmanlike, but there were a couple of dust ups after he made some great catches and great first downs and touchdowns. And obviously, he kind of saved his best performances for the huge games. He was very amped up against Tennessee, kind of brought an edge against Tennessee and Tuscaloosa when Alabama was trailing. Not much was going well for Jermaine Burton through his play and even sometimes his words. Kind of hyped up not only the team, but that whole crowd in Bryant Denny Stadium to the point where Alabama had a great second half and beat the Volunteers. And then obviously had a great performance against his old team, the Georgia Bulldogs. Kind of anytime you had that matchup, he was ready to go. And he certainly let the Georgia fan base know who the SEC champions were at the end of that championship game in Atlanta by running right over to them, making sure they knew to the point where I couldn't get an interview with him. I was scheduled to do an interview with him, and all of a sudden he came sprinting down the field and wanted to go say hello to his former fans that cheered for him at Georgia. But, he is an energetic player, and, it's something that I could see him probably growing out of. Some of the talk that goes around his game, but his game speaks loudly. I mean, he is a very physical wide receiver. He can really play in any type of role, whether he goes over the top of defenses, plays more in the slot. I think he's just somebody that is a very skilled wide receiver, knows the route tree extremely well. Bryce Young loved him. I mean, Bryce Young, he was one of the favorite targets that Bryce had looking back in 2022, and I think his production grew as Jalen Milroe got better a year ago for the Crimson Tide. So he definitely has an edge. He's definitely outspoken. He's definitely emotional, again, more so than most players we saw throughout the last few years that Coach Saban was in Tuscaloosa. But, I have a feeling he'll grow out of a lot of that once he gets to the NFL. Most players do, or else they don't last too long.
Speaking of Milroe, initial impressions of him and Kalen DeBoer's offense this weekend?
It seemed pretty clean from what we got to see. And again, I think a lot of things are watered down in all spring games. But for Milroe, it looked like his footwork was good. The arm strength's always been there with him. And it seems like he's grasping this offense a little quicker than I think some people expected. And he's just having fun. I mean, I think he is playing kind of pressure-free football, whereas a year ago, a spring practice going into summer camp, and then even the first few weeks of the season, I feel like he had the weight of the world on his shoulders at times and kind of worried about the next mistake. Could I lose my starting spot like he did with the loss against Texas? Didn't play at all in week three against South Florida before he earned the job back against Ole Miss and finally held on to it the rest of the year. I don't get the sense that he's looking over his shoulder at all this year. Kalen DeBoer has made it very clear all throughout spring practice that he is QB1 moving forward. And I think Jalen has proven he's a good leader, and he's proven he's good in crunch time. That 4th and 31 throw that he had against Auburn, not many quarterbacks can make. I mean, that throw was on the money at the back of the end zone from over 35 yards away. He made a great throw in that ball game, and obviously came close to getting in the tying touchdown against Michigan that could have changed the Rose Bowl, and who knows, maybe allowed Coach Saban to go out with a national championship. But he's really adapted well to this offense. It'll be interesting to see if the Crimson Tide keep adding some talent around him in the wide receiver room and the transfer portal. But we do know Alabama's going to run the football really well. They have a three-headed monster right now at running back with what we've already seen from Richard Young, Jam Miller, and then Justice Haynes. So I think Alabama's in good shape there. I think there's going to be a good mixture for football fans this year that kind of like the ground and pound type game that Alabama became known for with Derrick Henry and Trent Richardson, but they're going to air it out a little bit too, like we got to see with Tua and Bryce and now Jalen for the last few years.
Well, Richard, I don't think it's any coincidence that you joined us the day after the Jumbo Shrimp walked it off.
Great moments for the Jumbo Shrimp. No, I'm certainly thrilled they continue having success. Now they're in AAA. Definitely love that. Still really good friends with Scott Kornberg. He does a great job as their broadcaster. So I will always be a Jumbo Shrimp fan. I even wore a Jumbo Shrimp hat the other day on my walk around the neighborhood. So we're repping Duval up here in Birmingham, Alabama. I can tell you that.
I love it. Roger, when are we going to get you back here? We need you to have some of the shrimp in the waffle cone. That's all I need this summer is I need a Roger Hoover appearance.
Let's set up a Jacksonville Jumbo Shrimp or Jacksonville Suns Alumni Day, and I'm there. I look forward to getting back down there. I'm supposed to play golf at some point with Pedro Bragan, so you know, we're definitely going to make that happen at some point. So I'll let you guys know.
I love it. Fantastic. Thank you, as always, for being a friend and for joining us on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. Again, Roger Hoover, you can find him on X at @Roger_Hoover, and he is part of the Crimson Tide Sports Network. Thank you, brother.
Thank you. I'm a huge fan of all of you. Congratulations on the success of this show, and keep it moving forward. Really excited for you guys. Thank you. Duval.
Legend. Appreciate you. No, you couldn't wait to get that Duval out there, Roger. He is Duval through and through, a man who has traveled many miles through the Southeast between Alabama, his time at the University of Tennessee, but he will always be Duval. And he is the second of three guests on today's episode of Helmets and Heels. Taylor. Please tell us who's going to be joining us coming up in the 1 o'clock hour.
We have Coach Nick Lucco joining us. We're going to talk some Iceman hockey because playoffs start tomorrow here in town. So we're going to chat a little bit about where the team stands as they head into game one of the Kelly Cup playoffs.
That and some more Jags talk still to come on 1010XL and 92.5 FM.
Winters are mild.
All the time?
All the time.
Summers are hot.
The beach.
And everything in between is awesome.
Amazing, isn't it?
1010XL. This is the Duval Life.
You know, they say April showers bring May flowers, but about nigh, they're bringing more than just blooms this April. Pick and hear, gang. It's time to spring into action and refresh your vision for the brighter days ahead. Don't let cloudy vision rain on your parade. Dry eyes and allergies causing irritation to cataracts blurring your vision, Bowden Eye can help protect what's important to you. If you're experiencing problems with your vision, call or visit BowdenEye.com to schedule your consultation. Bowden Eye and Associates, keeping the First Coast focused.
Imagine a complete one-stop shop for all your company's technology needs. A Jacksonville business who keeps their customer service local, so you never get outsourced to a distant call center. When your company is ready for faster support for managed IT services, voice over IP phone systems, or access control, discover why so many business owners select Total Business Systems. Call 604-6900, 604-6900, or jacksitexperts.com.
An ACL tear can be a devastating injury with prolonged pain and rehabilitation. Hi, I'm Dr. George Bari. I'm a sports medicine orthopedic surgeon who grew up right here in Jacksonville and then went on to train with the world-renowned Dr. James Andrews. At Bari Orthopedics, we use the most current techniques to get you back on the field with less pain and quicker rehabilitation. We treat all types of sports injuries with the newest techniques available. Please call us for consultation or visit BariOrthopedics.com.
Find out more at BariOrthopedics.com. That's B-A-H-R-I Orthopedics.com.
Mia here. Looking to spruce up your home or business for the spring? Window Gang's exterior cleaning services will remove stubborn stains, restore windows to a clear shine, and ensure your gutters flow freely. Call 262-7300 for a free estimate.
Hey, it's Matt Hayes. 100% risk-free with Awaken 180. No subscriptions, no hidden fees, just a proven plan to lose weight. I did it, Dempsey did it, and now hackers transforming right in front of our very eyes. Results at Awaken180weightloss.com.
This date in sports history is brought to you by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
On April 17, 1974, at the Senior PGA Championship, Lee Trevino beats Jim Colbert by one stroke for his second title in the event.
Mia here, and we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino? Canceled, because real life came calling. MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. The live casino is so easy to use. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action's in the palm of your hands and you don't even need to wear pants. Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL. A revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. Sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win, only with MyBookie.
Florida Home AC, the official AC partner of the Jaguars. Make them your AC partner with honest cost estimates before they start the work with no hidden fees. Call 777-4300 for Florida Home AC.
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue. Because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow smoked pork. Enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
Life has its share of challenges, and when it puts you to the test, make sure you reach out to Rebound Rehabilitation to give you the quickest path back to full health and confidence. Rebound Rehab, specializing in helping patients overcome back pain and sciatica, arthritis, and fibromyalgia, just to name a few. Rebound Rehab, locations covering the entire First Coast, getting you back in control with a pain-free life. Sports injury, workplace injury, whatever it might be, you can rebound. Log on to reboundrehab.com for more info.
So you want a new ride, but you've got to get payments to fit your monthly budget, right? Well, if you want low payments, then you've got to go to Arlington Toyota Pre-Owned and save today. How does this sound? Just $500 down and $288 per month gets you a pre-owned 2021 Toyota Corolla. Or you choose a pre-owned 2021 Camry, RAV4, or Tacoma for just $500 down and $388 per month. Arlington Pre-Owned will even help you with your credit. Get a fresh start with help from Arlington's friendly Credit for Everyone pre-approval helper. It's all about getting you approved. And remember, you can buy pre-owned with total confidence thanks to Arlington's 30-day exchange program. That's 30 days to love your pre-owned purchase or exchange it. But don't wait. You got to go to Arlington Pre-Owned today if you want just $500 down, low payments, 30-day exchange, and friendly credit for everyone. Shop in person 10939 Atlantic Boulevard and online at arlingtontoyota.com today.
Hidden Hills Golf Club invites you to come out and experience one of the most beautiful and unique golf courses in North Florida. Affordable golf, friendly service, and great times in the Hills Grill after play. Book your tee time, HiddenHillsGC.com.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Helmets and Heels is switched on by
First Coast Lighting and Fans.
Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor on 1010XL.
Thanks again to Tyler Fornes, host on Score North and covers the Vikings for Sporting News, for joining us earlier about what the Vikings are going to do at pick 11, or if they move. And also to Roger Hoover, who just joined us, talking all things Alabama football, especially their prospects. We've got a pair of tickets to the annual Guns and Hoses Fight Night that happens this Saturday night at UNF Arena. 6:30 p.m. is when the fights begin. Be call number 4 at 641-1010. Call number 4, 641-1010. You win the pair of tickets, and of course, Dan and Jeff will be there as they always are. And if you've never been to Guns and Hoses, it is an absolute blast as you get to see the police fight the fighters, all for a good cause.
Far from the only thing going on at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena in the next 2 weeks, right? It is at ViStar. It's at the arena, correct?
The Iceman?
Yeah, no. Well, that's what I was alluding
yes.
to. I was
no,
saying
no. No, no. no the Guns N' Roses is at UNF.
Oh,
arena.
Okay. So, yeah, hey, yeah. Important programming note then.
Yes. Because that's why I said that.
Right.
I was like, hold
right.
on, what?
Right. So that's important to note then.
Yes.
Because in some years it's been there.
Yeah.
This year it's at UNF.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure you note that mm-hmm. so that you know, unlike me. And then also, you note that the Iceman will also be at the arena over the next 2 weeks for playoff hockey.
But the ViStar Arena.
Yes. Yes. Not yes. UNF Arena.
Correct. Yes. The
Don't
tickets
confuse
for
people.
Saturday night are for Guns N' Roses at UNF Arena. The Iceman tickets, you can buy them at any point in time. JacksonvilleIceman.com for the playoff tickets at the begin on Thursday and then also on Sunday. Those are at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. And on Friday, we'll have some tickets to give away. I'm not even going to tell anybody to what yet, but just think concert, and that also will be at ViStar Veterans Memorial Arena. All right, we're going to get more into Trevor Lawrence since he met with the media yesterday, get into some of his comments about play calling, and also Ryan Nielsen, his defensive coordinator. So certainly going to hear from the quarterback himself. That's coming up next right here on Helmets and Heels on 1010 XL and 92.5 FM.
You ever have that feeling
1010 XL?
Where you're not sure if you're awake or still dreaming?
All the time.
1010 XL.
I thought it wasn't real.
Your mind makes it real.
Hey, Jacksonville. I'm sure by now you've seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We are an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We are committed to customer service, reliability, and have unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today. GFL, green for life.
Hey, Hicken here, or just call me Danny Dreamfinders. For a limited time, on select move-in ready homes, Dreamfinders Homes is offering an amazing 3.99% interest rate in year one of your mortgage. Now is your chance to lock down the rate. You heard me right. 3.99% offer in year one. Visit DreamfindersHomes.com for sales event information and get the game. Interest rate available on select move-in ready homes. Restrictions and limitations apply. Go to DreamfindersHomes.com for more details.
It's Taylor Dahl from Helmets and Heels. You know, I've got to tell you about an amazing experience I had recently. I'm moving, which most of you know can be a very stressful time. I had to get my carpets cleaned, so of course I called up Zero Res, and let me tell you, they did not disappoint. Zero Res came in and worked their magic, leaving my carpets looking brand new. If you want impeccable service and a great deal, it saved me time, made my move a bit easier, and was less than if I took that apartment cleaning fee. Zero Res, spelled backward or forwards, is the right way to clean.
The flagship station of the Jaguars. WJXL AM Jacksonville Beach. WJXL FM Jacksonville Beach.
Imagine waking up this time next week and being 100% debt-free from credit cards, car loans, and personal loans. Hey, Prosser here. Loan Pronto's Equity Express line of credit can make it happen. Homeowners are turning their home equity into cash almost instantly. With Loan Pronto's AI-based system, you can get approval in about 10 minutes with almost no documentation, no appraisal, and no hassle. You can get hundreds of thousands of dollars out of your home. Use that money to pay off all your other loans. The average homeowner saves over $850 a month doing this. Listen, your home value's way up. You can use that to wipe out all those credit cards. Get some money for a home improvement. Literally hundreds of thousands are at your fingertips, and approval is just minutes away. So call now, 904-999-1508. 904-999-1508, or go to loanpronto.com. NMLS 1661781, subject to lender approval, equal housing lender.
This is former NFL quarterback David Garrard. If your knees have taken a beating and you're finally ready to do something about it, then let Southeast Orthopedic take a look. Come on, do your knees a favor.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
David Garrard here. I've had the PRP treatment from Southeast Orthopedic Specialists, and my knees are really doing well. Platelet-rich plasma treatment may be the answer for whatever is hurting you.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialists.
Tired of dealing with clogged drains? What about bad smells coming from your pipes? No matter how big or small your commercial or residential project may be, my friends at Duck Duck Rooter can handle it. Contact them today for all your plumbing, septic, and air conditioning needs at 904-862-6769. And while I have your attention, Duck Duck Rooter is hiring plumbers. They offer excellent weekly pay, health insurance, paid holidays, 401k, and more. Apply now at duckduckrooter.com, and they will call you for an interview.
Mortgage rates have lowered going into this spring selling season. Have you had problems selling your home in the past? Are you looking for a promise, a solution? I'm here to give it for you. It's Chad and Sandy and ChadandSandy.com, the real estate experts I trust and recommend with the sale of your home or mine for that matter. Maybe you want maximum equity or perhaps you're worried about costly repairs or upgrades. Chad and Sandy deliver this simple promise. They guarantee your home sold at an agreed upon price and deadline or they will buy it. You have literally nothing to lose. Take Pete in Lakeshore. I was in a pickle. I heard Chad and Sandy on the radio and called because I needed to cash out on a rental property fast. I was struggling to rent it. I called Chad and Sandy, and I got an offer for full asking price within days. These guys made it easy and delivered big-time results. Call the agents I trust and recommend to sell your home. Chad and Sandy, they guarantee to sell your home or they will buy it. Find out more at ChadandSandy.com or call 414-6200.
This is Molly McDonald with your 1010XL Southeast Orthopedic Specialist Local Sports Update. Brought to you by Jacksonville Hearing and Balance Institute. The Gators baseball team redeemed themselves by run ruling the JU Dolphins 12-1 last night. Tyler Shelnett led the bats with his first career multi-homer game. Jack Caglin was the talk of the night after a 516-foot home run. Head coach Kevin O'Sullivan is pleased with his team, but still believes they are using one too many pitchers to get through these games.
At some point, we're going to have to really put this thing together on the mound. And it's not like we're not capable. There's too many free passes. We're using one too many pitchers to get through the first half of the game or first, you know, whatever part of the game. We're always one pitch away or one inning away. It's fortunate enough for us that we were able to take advantage of the 10-run rule tonight because then it shortened the game.
Round one of the Kelly Cup playoffs are tomorrow as the Jacksonville Icemen face off against the Florida Everblades at home. Puck drop, 7 o'clock. It's 82 degrees at 1 o'clock. Time and temp brought to you by Bueller Air Conditioning. Stay cooler with Bueller.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville.
Light up your lunch with Helmets and Heels.
Presented by First Coast Lighting and Fans.
On 1010XL.
Okay, who picked Mariah Carey?
I did.
I love this song.
You know, I'm not the biggest Mariah Carey fan, but for you, Taylor Doll, I will love it.
I love it, her especially this era of Mariah. Like, it just makes you want to dance. But this song is also re-popular on TikTok right now, so it's, like, trending with the Gen Zers.
How do songs, like, suddenly resurface?
There's been a lot this last
commercials
year.
Can do it
yeah.
for certain
right.
songs.
Movies, sometimes
but, like, on
shows.
TikTok in particular. Like, all of a sudden, this song from, like, the early 2000s yeah. is just, like, bad.
I'll be honest, like, a lot of times it's the artist on TikTok. Like, Mariah will make a video doing a dance of one of her old songs, and then the TikTokers try to do that dance, and then it turns into, like, a trend. So a lot of them are that.
Since we're on social media, how many hours a day do you think people who are on Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok spend doing all that? Like, I don't...
You mean, like, influencers or just, like, a
no,
casual...
No, I just mean the people who just absorb
consumers.
That information. Yeah, consumers. Like, how many hours a day to get all... To see everything that's possible on all of those every day? I feel like that's not possible.
I
Facebook. I didn't even throw in Facebook.
Because I'm on all of the sites, but I don't spend hours, and I'm also working a lot of the day. Maybe if I didn't, I would consume more. But I still, like, there's certain times where I'm like, okay, I've got to get off this phone because I'm just in this rabbit hole of videos. some people, I'm sure, do spend, like, a work day of time.
Yeah,
because
YouTube also, I didn't throw that in there. Like, that's another
one.
Yeah,
the YouTube's a big one, too. Mm-hmm. I think that's why you
Watch
see.
Watch our YouTube, but no one else.
Right. Yeah. I think that's why you see so many people walking around with the AirPods in now, like, even around our office, which, like, I do encourage it in the multimedia department because it's important for us to mm-hmm. learn about what trends are and what's working for other brands and outlets and how we can incorporate that. So I do encourage it. But I mean, when I've, you know, taught at UNF or just walking around high school campuses when I was working in local television covering sports games, there's moments where I'm like, back in my day, if you had your cell phone out, and again, back in my day was 12, 13 years ago, if you had your cell phone out, even during a college class, like, they were looking at you a little funny. Do they just... You're allowed to just have your cell phone out in the middle of the school day? Like,
out here just scrolling? Like, I think you do. Like, I don't know if it's
somebody
like
wants to let us know.
Yes. 641-1010. Is this like a post-pandemic thing? Like, do we have high school kids like listening to Helmets and Heels right now while they're just also scrolling in the middle of like geometry or something? Like,
I don't recommend that.
Yeah. But
you're in school, you should be listening to your professor, teacher, what have you.
I think it's a reality.
On their computers and tablets and stuff now. A lot of high schools are just kind of like, you're in a classroom, but a lot of your work is there. So maybe it is a thing where they can just put on their headphones and do what they need to do.
Yeah,
back in the day, they would take your phone in a second.
I am very put the phone away. Mm-hmm. Like if I'm at a meeting with clients or if we're at dinner or something, the phone is such a distraction. Mm-hmm. Because the moment it lights up, you're like, oh, what? And it can be an email that you don't even care about from, you know, a brand that you bought once 3 years ago and you haven't unsubscribed. Anyway.
See, my phone's always on do not disturb, so.
Very smart. Although I will say, every time I go to text you, I have to click the notify anyway. And
well,
I'm like,
I have you as the acceptance. So I don't know why it still tells you that, because there's certain people, like my
it's
work.
It's just the weekends when we're not working.
Yeah, well, no, it's every day. Kidding. I have every day, except when I'm sleeping. My sleeping is full on, other than like my emergency. Like my brother, my grandparents, but work people in normal hours of the day, I have everybody allowed to text me, but outside of that, I do not.
Well, that's probably a lot of times because I'm texting at 7 o'clock in the morning when you're probably still sleeping. Okay, let's get it to the Trevor Lawrence audio. He met with the media yesterday. I want to start with the first two comments he had to say about play calling, because on the program yesterday, I read Alessandra Pontbriand's tweet. And she said that he doesn't know which way the play calling is going to go as far as Doug or press. But then he elaborated it a little bit more. So I want you to hear it directly from him. Here's the first comment he says on if he knows who will call plays this season.
I mean, whichever way that goes, we're gonna make the most of it, and it's going to be great. I don't know. I haven't had any conversations about, you know, anything necessarily changing or staying the same. So I don't really know. I'm with you guys. But we've had success with both guys calling the plays in the past. And even last year, obviously, we could have been better offensively, but we did have some success. And I do like the continuity, the consistency that I have with press. I know him really well. You know, I think that's a good thing that we're keeping that intact, because it's hard as a quarterback to change.
So why not lead with that? Why not lead with, well, I hope it's press because consistency is key to me, as opposed to, well, yeah, whichever way it goes, you know, like, you know, it could go either way. But, you know, I think it's going to be press. I have an expectation. But whichever way it goes.
Yeah. To Mia's point, this is the second half of his answer on press Taylor. Exactly.
I like where we're at. And I think that we've made some really necessary changes this offseason already. And now we just got to implement them and get great at it. You know, I think it's about creating an identity and being really good at what we do. And I think we have a clear vision and picture of what that is. And I'm excited, you know, and I'm expecting it to be press at this point, because that's kind of the direction we've been heading and what I expect, and I'm not hearing anything. So that's where we're going, and I'm excited for it.
That's so interesting.
RJ, conspiracy music, X-Files, please, if you could. I've been saying this for weeks, for months now. Even if Trevor Lawrence, week 16, the Jaguars are 14-2, or I guess 13-2, whatever you want to say, he will still be standing up there saying, press is doing a great job. Yeah, you know, the offense is really structured. And we will never find out who is calling the plays.
I mean, hopefully we know, because if it's Doug, I feel like we should notice a change.
Maybe we will, but maybe Doug will say, press has grown as a play caller.
Yeah, because remember, the end of the day, Doug Peterson wants his proteges, that's what I'll call press, his offensive coordinator, to be able to grow as far as their careers are concerned. Mm-hmm. That's, I think, why this all started, was Doug really wants press to be elevated in the eyes around the NFL of people who will hire him to be a head coach. And his coaching tree, so to speak, he wants to be able to flourish. The problem is sometimes your coaching tree isn't as good as you are at the job. And so that's what, but I don't blame Press Taylor for last season. I blame the offensive line for last season, leading obviously to Trevor's injuries, but also just how poor of a job they did running the football. Their blocking was atrocious, and therefore that's why we saw Trevor trying to do it all himself and reach his throwing arm into the end zone, right? Like, that shouldn't happen. I don't think that's a Press Taylor thing. I think that's a Trevor taking it on himself thing, because he knows his offensive line isn't blocking. So I don't spend, or I don't lose sleep over who's exactly going to be calling plays, because I think Doug Peterson now has a defensive coordinator, and we'll get to Trevor's comments on Nielsen in a second, has a defensive coordinator who he can trust, so therefore he can spend more time in the offense. And I'm not saying Doug didn't trust Mike Caldwell, but I think he did trust him. But it didn't lead to a great defense, so therefore he felt like he had to spend more time on the defensive side and not enough time on the offensive side.
Yeah, I think he trusted Mike. I think it really came down to, at least from what I've been told, the micromanaging side of things. Mike was is a good person. He's a good coach. But just because you're a good coach, are you overseeing and making sure the coaches beneath you are doing their job, that they are having communication amongst each other, that they are corresponding between position groups to say, we want to do this, we're going to do that, how do we bring these things in harmony? And that's why Doug was so heavily involved on that side of the ball last year, because I think he recognized that there were some shortcomings despite the success of the 2022 season, and said, I need to make sure that that communication is occurring between the different position groups. And that's why he stepped away from the offense a little bit. He trusted Press Taylor and the rest of the offensive coaches. And perhaps, you know, maybe it wasn't exactly what Doug envisioned the offense would be.
Right. And it's one thing, Taylor, to delegate responsibilities if you have people that are doing a great job. It's another thing to delegate responsibilities if you realize at some point they're not doing a great job. You have to step in and take more control.
Yeah, I mean, I personally think there were definitely moments last year where Press Taylor was, the play calling was a problem. There were a lot of other factors throughout the year, but there were moments, key moments, you can point to that. But in addition, as an offensive coordinator, your job goes beyond that. And we talk a lot about the play calling, but now we're talking about reportedly players not understanding a playbook. And we talked about week 18 of football and people not being in the right spot. There were still a lot of issues that were not being addressed on that offense that falls on Press Taylor too. And it does fall on Doug too. But at some point, as your offense is your baby and it's your job to make them as good as possible, even despite injuries, and you see other teams around the league also banged up and you don't see them completely just melt down at the end of the season, and you did see that here in Jacksonville, and some of that does fall on Press, because when things should have shifted and changed or maybe adjusted certain situations, if Calvin cannot figure out the playbook, find a way that he could find some plays that he can do and can understand and be in the right spot, and none of that happened in 18 weeks of football.
Or Parker Washington, who 21-year-old rookie, his, in the words of Quincy Williams, his head is in a beehive. That's for most rookies. Mm-hmm. But he made some acrobatic catches, some touchdowns that changed the trajectory of some games, even if the outcome wasn't what, you know, Jaguar fans were hoping for. Did he have the command of the playbook that he probably should have had at that juncture when he was thrust into action when Christian Kirk went down? I saw somebody went through and did the math of like how many of Trevor's injuries stemmed from someone either missing a check or missing an alert at the line or not knowing, you know, where to go or something like that. And a couple of them were Parker. And that's no knock on him. Again, he's a rookie. Things happen. But when you have a veteran in Calvin Ridley who's missing things and then you have a rookie who's missing things, are you telling me both guys don't know what they're doing, or are you telling me there's miscommunication all around? Because once is an anomaly, twice says to me it's becoming a pattern. And not to mention, Elijah Cooks couldn't get on the field until what? Week 7?
Yeah.
Week 8?
Yeah.
And I understand there was a logjam in the room, but was he not prepared? Like, whose responsibility is that then?
And you think that's what Trent Baalke was alluding to when he said the onboarding process.
Very much so.
Yeah. Yeah, is that the coaches weren't doing their jobs, which of course, there's always a little bit of a GM head coach power struggle if things don't go well. Mm-hmm. There might be a power struggle even if things do go well in every NFL city, but certainly we believe here that there's a little bit of a power struggle because the GM's saying, I'm drafting well and I'm signing good free agents, but the coaches aren't coaching them. And then, of course, on the coaching side, you're going to say, we're doing a great job, but we don't have talented enough players in here, whether it's from the draft or from free agency, trades, what have you. So that's where there's always the green.
And Lauren, too, to your point when you were talking about Doug and wanting his coaching tree to succeed and move on, a couple seasons ago, Press Taylor was in talks for a head coaching job, and now that's probably backed up a lot because of what was almost forced last season. And so sometimes you do have to analyze that, too. Like, are you forcing a situation and making this coach look worse than what he is? Because I think the Bears were one of the teams talking about potentially getting Press Taylor a couple seasons ago. So when you look at those, like, there's a way to do it, and there's a way to let these guys flourish and be looked at in a positive light, but without making them do a job that maybe they're not going to excel at.
Back to the point about Trent's sense of, I provide you the players, it's now your job to coach them. from what I've been told, this is from sources both here but also in the Bay Area, Trent has been very receptive to, if there's a player that coaches really want and they've stressed that we need this type of player or this is one of my guys, like this is who I'm targeting, he's been very open to that here in Jacksonville, maybe even more so than he was in San Francisco. And so that's where, if that is true, I can understand his frustration of, you said you wanted this guy, i.e. Tank Bigsby, and now you're not playing him. Like, what do you want me to do? Like, that's, you know, there's only so much I can do in that regards.
Yeah, and Tank Bigsby is one of the most interesting ones because throughout training camp, we all thought, could he push Etienne for playing time this season? I mean, my goodness, this guy
I went on
is...
Levitard's show and I said it, so yes.
Yeah, this guy's electric. He's built power. I mean, he's powerful. He's built, like, wow, what a great job drafting him.
Yeah.
And then when the fumbles happened and then he didn't know about the special teams issue and things like that, that's when it was, okay, well, we can't give him as much playing time. And then, of course, Etienne got too many touches. And then Doug said at the owners' meetings, we need to back off as many touches as Etienne got. Okay, well, you had a guy there in Bigsby, and obviously things didn't work out the way that everyone envisioned. And that's one of the things that you learn from training camp going over many, many years, is there are always players that are going to shine. And certainly Ridley, for me, watching him in training camp, watching his footwork was, and then watching him play too, it was like, oh my gosh, this guy is going to have 1,800 yards this season. Like when he said however many yards he said, he is going
1,400 yards with a broken foot.
Yeah, I thought he's going to have, you know, like I said, 1,800 yards. He was going to be like Tyreek Hill closing in on 2,000 yards just from what we saw. And then obviously games, it doesn't always translate. All right, so when we talk about Trevor Lawrence in the future here, I am not worried in the least about when it comes time for him to get paid that Shad Khan will pay him. Of course, the question is, does he do enough this season for that monster contract? Has Trevor even thought about an extension? Here he is on that.
Yeah, I mean, there's definitely been some conversations. You know, as far as where that's at now, it's not really my focus. You know, I'd love to obviously be a Jag. So for as long as possible, we love it here. And I love where we're headed as an organization and feel like I'm just getting better every year. And my best ball is definitely ahead of me. So from that standpoint, obviously, yeah, that would be great. But like you said, it's going into my fourth year. It's not like this is necessarily going to be my last season. You know, there's a lot that could happen. So not really my focus right now.
Yeah, and from what I've been told, the conversations have been ongoing. Maybe not as front of mind as the Josh Allen deal, which was a bit more pressing than an extension for Trevor Lawrence, who, of course, could play on the fifth-year option next season, which I fully expect Trent Baalke and company to announce, if not at tomorrow's pre-draft luncheon, then at some point in the next 2 weeks that they are extending or they are picking up the fifth-year option. In my opinion, it'll be for both Trevor and Travis Etienne, but we'll see what actually is ultimately decided. And it's not the end of the world if he has to play on the fifth-year option, even though, you know, in the words of Jalen Ramsey, you can play on the fifth year, then they can tag you, then they can tag you again. We saw it with Lamar Jackson. I don't think we will see a Lamar Jackson situation with Trevor Lawrence. I think the point we're at right now, and from what I've been told with regards to the negotiations, it's at this interesting juncture where he and his team recognize that he did not perform to the level that they anticipated he would this past offseason, where it's a no-brainer, you throw him $50 million a year, it's over. So they recognize that, and they are willing to give and take because of that, so that, to Trevor's point, because he said, he was very open, he's like, I would like for the deal to be done, so then I just don't worry, and I just play football, and everything's A-okay. And so that's where, for that peace of mind, are they willing to maybe take a little bit less than, let's say he goes out and he performs the way everyone expects him to in 2024, and he is a top five quarterback. Well, now all of a sudden, here's the money. Mm-hmm. He didn't really sound like, in that clip, a guy who's so hell-bent on, well, I'm going to bet on myself and get the bag afterwards. You know, like, I'm focused on this. He sounded like a guy who wants the security so he can just focus on playing football. And from everything I've been told, that is the same vibe that his camp and the Jaguars, the conversations they've had. I've heard some people say the thought is, could they hammer it out before the start of the season? We know Trent Baalke doesn't do in-season contracts, in-season contract extensions. I think there's potential for that, for it to get done at some point before the season opener. But I also think that what we saw from Patrick Mahomes, where he did sign the mega contract, they have since thrown the mega contract out and built another mega contract that behooves the team while still affording Patrick Mahomes what he deserves. Mm-hmm. I could see a situation like that where maybe they agree on a deal in August. Trevor does ball out in 2024. And then 2-3 years from now, they're like, actually, let's like amend that contract and do a different 7-8 year deal.
Mm-hmm. Which honestly, I feel like teams are starting to do that now because they're figuring out, let me make this guy happy, lock him down, make it seem like, okay, here's a kind of idea of a number that we can give him. And then in a couple years, once things pan out and you kind of see, like, especially with the Patrick Mahomes and the Chiefs, for example, they see, and Patrick Mahomes sees, like, there's many more Super Bowls he could win if he wanted to. And there's factors that come into that, and money is a part of it. I've talked to several people when it comes, you know, like SpotTrack and all of the contract people, and they don't think they see another Patrick Mahomes-esque contract coming just because it was so unique and in a lot of varieties. But I think with Trevor, I think also Trevor notices that he hasn't played at the level a lot of people have expected, so he's not going to be there clamoring about a contract right now when he knows he still has things to prove.
Yeah, I think at the end of the day, Trevor also is very smart in this fact. He's going to get multiple contracts over the lifetime mm-hmm. of his career. So even if, let's say, he didn't end up in Jacksonville, someone else is going to pay him a lot of money to go play there, right? So even if he took a deal that wasn't the highest paid quarterback in the National Football League now, he knows the second contract's out there, and if he does play to his abilities, he'll get another monster contract. So that's where it's, to me, so different from a quarterback perspective than almost any other player on the football field, certainly running backs, as we know. But even tackles, they don't always get that huge money in the second contract. Certainly defensive ends can, and edge rushers can, certain players can. But I think if you're Trevor, you just sit back, you go, all right, I'm going to focus on this season because I want to win football games. Mm-hmm. That's what we all enjoy. And the money is great. But at the end of the day, I know I'm going to get paid no matter what.
Now, on the Jaguars side, because do you think it would be smart for them to do it before the season?
Yes.
Because, number one, you're not having to deal with another increase of money that they get off season,
yeah,
and getting all the contracts coming up. But also, if he does, let's say, whatever, if he has some phenomenal season this year, that bar raises even more. So on the Jack side, it would probably be smart to come up with something before the season starts.
I understand I'm comparing dollars and cents to draft picks, but if the Minnesota Vikings are to spend 2, if not 3 first round picks on JJ McCarthy, I mean, the price of the dollar when it comes to a quarterback yeah. is just so astronomically high.
Yeah.
You didn't have to give up draft capital to get this guy. You mm-hmm. know, at his worst, I mean, outside of the ball security, he's what? Top. If you take the ball security out of it, which I understand is a very important part of the game.
Sure.
But if you take those 60 turnovers out of it, he's what? At minimum, a top 15, top 12 quarterback? Mm-hmm. There are teams dying on the vine for a top 15, top 12 guy.
Yeah, imagine the Jets. Let's say Aaron Rodgers gets hurt again week 1. The Jets would give up so much if they had it. They've already given up a lot, though. But to get someone like Trevor Lawrence, right? Like, that's why I say Trevor knows in yeah. his heart of hearts he's going to get paid a lot of money, whether it's here, whether it's somewhere else. He likes it here, so yeah. hopefully here. But he doesn't have to worry about that.
Look at Carolina last year. Carolina gave the Bears 2 firsts, 2 seconds, and DJ Moore to get Bryce Young.
Exactly. And we all saw what Bryce Young was this past season. Maybe he'll get better. Yeah. Maybe they'll improve around him, but we shall see. All right, we're going to talk hockey when we come back. We'll get to Trevor Lawrence's comment on Ryan Nielsen as well. You're listening to Helmets and Heels on 1010 XL 92.5 FM.
Helmets and Heels. This hour is brought to you by First Coast Honda Dealers. It started with a dream.
I wanted to be a senator.
I wanted to be a florist.
International house pancake.
And it turned into The Franchi Show.
Are we ready? Yes. Good.
Afternoons on 1010 XL.
Mia here, and we've all been there before. A weekend trip to the casino canceled because real life came calling. MyBookie's new and improved online casino is here to change the game. Dive into a truly realistic casino experience featuring the latest in slots, progressive jackpots, and live dealer action, all from the comfort of your own home. The live casino is so easy to use, folks. Just go to MyBookie and click Live Casino at the top. You'll find live dealers ready to deal or spin just like you're at the casino. The MyBookie Casino provides a Las Vegas experience when the action is in your hands. And yes, the rumors are true. You don't even have to wear pants.
Start at MyBookie today with a generous sign-up bonus using promo code 1010XL, and a revamped loyalty program ensures a host of exclusive VIP perks. Sign up and hit the casino with promo code 1010XL. The more you play, the more you win, only with MyBookie.
Hacker here, and I'm loving the doors that are now opening now that I'm down almost 50 pounds. Oh, yeah, and those results are in just 7 weeks with Awaken 180 weight loss. By doors, I mean opportunities I've avoided because of my weight, like an all-day adventure to SeaWorld or spending 3 days at Walt Disney World. Did I gain the normal 5 to 10 pounds I would have at Disney? Of course not. In fact, I lost 3 pounds. Last week at Disney, thanks to the good folks at Awaken 180. Awaken 180 travels with you, and I'm eating all sorts of foods, salmon, ground beef, broccoli, cabbage, collard greens, you name it. It's not a lie when I say I'm eating to lose weight is the only way to lose weight. Do what we all did, Matt, Mike, and myself. Call Awaken 180 Weight Loss, 844-346-1800. That's 844-346-1800, or go online, awaken180weightloss.com.
Let's fire up the flavor and ignite those appetites. Let's slow down and smell the barbecue, because all your favorites are smoked for hours and ready for eating when you are. From our famous ribs to slow smoked pork, enjoy some perfection by the plateful, safely in our dining room or in the comfort of your home. With curbside pickup, drive-through, and delivery. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmasters since 68.
If you're a business owner and want to learn about federal, state, or local government contracts, plan to attend a free online webinar April 23rd. The Florida Apex Accelerator, in partnership with UNF, provides expert guidance and consultations at no cost. The Apex Accelerator program can make selling to the government less complicated. To attend the free Coffee and Contracting webinar April 23rd, register at unf.edu/sbdc. Then select Training and Event tab.
I'm Hacker, and Denny Thompson and I will navigate you through the Florida football offseason during the Gator Bites podcast, presented by Southeast Orthopedic Specialists. New episodes drop every Friday. Get Gator Bites where you find podcasts.
Mia here, and if you want low payments, then you've got to go to Arlington Toyota Pre-Owned and save today. How does this sound? Just $500 down and only $288 per month gets you a pre-owned 2021 Toyota Corolla. Or you choose a pre-owned 2021 Camry, RAV4, or Tacoma for just $500 down and $388 per month. Plus, Arlington's Credit for Everyone program and 30-day exchange. Don't wait. Save thousands and shop ArlingtonToyota.com today.
Want to pay less to vacation more? General RV makes that possible and even more affordable during the model year closeout, April 17th through the 21st. 5 days of savings and free family activities with the best deals on travel trailers, motorhomes, fifth wheels, and more. Guaranteed. Get to the model year closeout where you can pay less to vacation more, just how you want it. Only at General RV in Orange Park on Wells Road off 295.
Hey there, Jacksonville. With scorching temperatures just around the corner, it's crucial to ensure your AC is blowing nice and cool. Duck Duck Air Conditioning is here to keep you comfortable all summer long. But don't wait until the heat gets here. Our service techs are ready right now to handle any cooling issues you may have at your home or business. Call Duck Duck AC today at 904-862-6769 to schedule. That's 904-862-6769. Duck Duck Air Conditioning, online at duckduckac.com.
Hey sports fans, it's Ace Carline for Kingfish Pest Control. Are mosquitoes turning your outdoor fun into a full contact sport? Time to call in Kingfish Pest Control. I can tell you from my own experience, they are the MVPs of mosquito elimination. See for yourself. Call Kingfish Pest Control today and get an unbeatable 50% off your first treatment. That's right. Sign up for a full season of lockdown coverage and get 50% off your first treatment. Don't let mosquitoes steal your home field advantage. Reclaim your yard with Kingfish Pest Control.
This is Nye Lauren Stample, former Florida State National Champion and the proud owner of NLS Cleaning. Just like on the gridiron, we tackle dirt and grime with unmatched precision. Whether it's your commercial property or your residential space, we are ready to take care of your exterior cleaning needs. NLSCleaning.net.
Everyone seems to be in a time crunch these days. Well, don't forget, you can always count on the cold case at Daly's. Always convenient, always cold. Whether it's the King of Beers, Natty Light, Stella, or Cigar City, a Goose Island Bud Light Seltzer. Dash into Daly's and grab one to go.
1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555. Jacksonville. Let's ring up another guest on the All-Pro Roofing phone line. Helmets and Heels is brightened by
First Coast Lighting and Fans
on 1010XL.
All right, if you hear that sound, you know what it means, and it means the Jacksonville Icemen scored a goal. If you have not, then you need to get there this week to watch some Icemen playoff hockey. We are joined now by Coach Nick Lucco. Coach, thanks for hopping on with us.
Thanks for having me. How's everyone doing today?
We are great. I'm pumped. I love playoff hockey. I love Icemen hockey, so I'm ready to go. The hated Everblades, Coach. Series starts tomorrow at home, 7 p.m. drop. Let's start there. Let's start where the Icemen sit right now. I know it's the kind of time of year where a lot of guys going up and down between AHL and back down to the Icemen. So tell us kind of where we're sitting with the roster and what we're expecting heading into game one.
Yeah. You know, just wrapping up the regular season here. We've got a couple injuries here and there, but everyone's pretty banged up this time of year. Our affiliate in Rochester's having a great year as well. So they're ready to make a playoff push, and there are a few guys who've played for us who are up there right now that could be back anytime soon. But, you know, for now, we're really happy with where our group is at. We're excited for game one tomorrow night.
The Icemen will play the Florida Everblades, who, head coach Nick Lucco of the Icemen, we did the math yesterday. Between the Everblades and the Icemen, I believe it's a 25-24 mark that Jacksonville has the advantage over the past however many seasons. What is it about those boys from South Florida, or I guess from Southwest Florida, I should say, that it just brings out a different emotion between these two sides?
Yeah, I mean, it's been something that's been building for years. And, you know, teams that are coming from the same state that have really good programs that go on playoff runs, and then you eventually play each other in the playoffs, that's going to build that hatred. So, this is year three in a row playing against these guys. I know they don't like us. We don't like them. So, to me, I'm extremely excited about this opportunity. I love a good rival and, you know, can't wait for tomorrow night.
Yes, we're very excited about it. All right, so you grew up in and around hockey. How have you noticed, though, that the Jacksonville hockey scene has grown up in the last few years?
It's been unbelievable. Just in the last couple of years, you know, obviously with the Igloo being renovated and reopened and adding that second sheet of ice and seeing our youth program, you know, quadruple in size, if not more, over the last couple of years. It's great to see the game of hockey grow in this area, and Jacksonville's quickly turning into a hockey town.
I love it. It's been really fun to watch the progress of not only the Icemen, the product on the ice, but obviously everything that kind of surrounds what goes into the day-to-day of Icemen hockey. So, Coach, I think it's pretty obvious. We talk about it in every sport, but how important is it to get that home ice advantage to start off a series like this for the Kelly Cup playoffs?
Yeah, it's huge, especially for us. You know, in Jacksonville, we're the number one attendance in the league, second in all of minor league hockey here. So for us to get those crowds every night, we can feed off of that energy. We know the crowd's going to get behind us and give us that extra push, especially in the crunch times. So we're really looking forward to it.
I think what's fascinating, Nick, is when you look at the stats from the ECHL this past season, we could start on the defensive-ish side of the puck, of the ice, I should say. I think that was the right terminology there. Cam Johnson of the Everblades leads the league in terms of goalie wins and save percentage and several other statistical marks. But then what's fascinating is when you go through total points, whether it's for forwards or defensemen, you don't see either the Icemen, any individual Icemen or any individual Everblades pop up as a leading goal scorer or a leading point getter in the ECHL. What does that say about the continuity, despite the fact that you have players moving up to the AHL and back, that you guys have been able to develop as well as your counterparts down in Fort Myers?
Yeah, I think both teams would say they rely on their depth quite a bit. It's not just one guy every night scoring. It's multiple guys. You know, we've had a bunch of games this year where we've scored four or five goals in a game, and we've had four or five different goal scorers, and they'd probably say the same thing. So for the fan, it's going to be awesome hockey to watch because it's going to be nonstop, in your face, you know, shift after shift. There's going to be good players on the ice at all times.
How much does home ice mean to your guys, to you? Can you feel the excitement from the crowd?
Yeah, I love it. I mean, I get chills every once in a while when the crowd gets nice and loud and then gets on the other team, especially the goalie after a goal against. So I love it. I know the players love it. And, you know, when you look at a series that's 2-3-2, you know, we only have to go down to Fort Myers once. So to limit that travel and be able to sleep in your own beds at home and kind of stay in that, you know, normal routine, that's huge for us.
Do the official rink dogs, Ole and Blue, do they get to travel when you guys do?
I wish. My fiance wouldn't like that, though. So he's got to stay home and protect her while I'm on the road.
They are cuties. I saw a video just recently of them on Twitter, and it looks like they're ready for some playoff hockey, too. Coach, let's look a little bit at the goalies for this series. When you look at the Everblades, Cam Johnson sits in that top eight for save percentage, and then we know here in Jacksonville it's been really fun to watch both Matt Vernon and Joe Merdaka, but thoughts on them and what we can expect from them this series?
Yeah, I mean, goaltending's going to be at a premium for both teams. You know, a lot of good goaltenders on both sides. And we even had Michael Hauser, who's been up in Rochester, play really well for us this year, too. For Cam Johnson, he's a guy who's, you know, back-to-back champion. He really turns it on this time of year. So for us, we're going to have to get to him early and, you know, look to pop a couple. I think when Florida has a lead, they you know, tend to pack it in and play really well defensively. So for us, hot starts is going to be key.
Offense sells tickets. It's that defense that wins championships. Nick
exactly.
Rucco, the head coach of the Iceman, joining us on the All-Pro Roofing Hotline. And before we let you go, Nick, I do want to give a shout-out, and I'll give you the floor as well, to kudos to the Iceman for receiving the ECHL Hockey Operations Department of the Year Award. Just speak to now, I believe this is what, year two or year three for you?
This is year three.
Year three, how the organization surrounding the play on the ice and what it has meant to be a part of it.
Yeah, it's been outstanding, to say the least. It starts with ownership. Andy Kaufman's a wonderful human being, unreal owner, and an even better person. He's all about taking care of you know, his family and the players and the staff and treating them like family. So since day one of my time here, it's been outstanding. And then, you know, just for the rest of our staff, we got a group of people who work for the team that, you know, work hard every day and do whatever it takes to help give the players the best chance of succeeding every night. So I'm extremely proud of our staff here.
All right, Coach Lucco, thanks so much for hopping on. Good luck this week. I know tomorrow we have 7 p.m. puck drop. Sunday is going to be a 3 p.m. puck drop, and then you hit the road for a little bit. Hopefully we can just finish it off with the sweep. That'd be fun. But I know it's definitely been one of those series that have been back and forth and fun. Again, good luck, and I'll see you Thursday.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thanks for having me.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
There he goes, Nick Lucco, the head coach of the Jacksonville Icemen. Unfortunately, ladies, the Jacksonville Icemen, the line for tomorrow's game is not on mybookie.ag, but there are several other lines I do want to get to.
Now, Mia's Midday My Bookie Picks. Experience the Vegas thrill from the comfort of your phone anytime, anywhere, only with My Bookie.
The NBA play-in tournament continues this evening. We did see the Golden State Warriors, the end of the dynasty, last night, ousted. I've seen several quotes regarding the Warriors. This is what they were all season, a 9 or a 10 seed that ultimately would not make the NBA playoffs. I don't think the same can be said for the Miami Heat. If you saw online already, ET did our MyBookie picks on social this morning. He picked the 76ers to cover 5.5 points at home up in the city of brotherly love. I disagree. I will never question or doubt Jimmy Butler and Heat culture once they hit the postseason. Eric Spoelstra, I mean, it's kind of like the cockroaches. Like, he is one of the things that will be left when all is said and done. Somehow finding a way to squeeze every ounce of talent out of that Miami Heat roster. And so I do like Miami to cover tonight up in Philadelphia. Taylor?
Mm-hmm.
The Chicago Bulls are 3-point favorites over the Atlanta Hawks. Wow. I haven't watched a ton of Atlanta Hawks basketball this year, but if Jeff Prosser's rants in the morning are anything I need to know, as well as my general knowledge of the Eastern Conference in the NBA, I don't want to call it a loser leaves town, but it's two franchises that at different points this year, people were like, is this an NBA team? Like, they had a team meeting 3 games in.
Yeah.
I'll pick Billy Donovan and company to cover, but I'm not so sure how I feel about it, Taylor.
Yeah, me either. I'm honestly surprised we're favorites. We just lost by 11 to them a couple weeks ago. So it'll be interesting, but the Bulls are such a weird team. There's games where they've beat teams where you feel like there's no way that they should have beat them, and then they lose by 15 to one of the worst teams in the league. So they're so unpredictable. It really just counts on DeMar being on his game, Kobe White being on his game. Those are two big factors that have been a part of the Bulls recently. I don't know if you remember last year when DeMar DeRozan's daughter was like caused some chaos at one of the games because she was yelling and people were the other team was.
She was a great meme
yeah,
for a couple of weeks.
Fantastic.
But then it like got weird on social.
Started being really mean and threatening her. And I'm like, you guys got to relax.
That's
a little
social
girl.
Media for you.
Yeah. But bad news, she will not be in attendance for the play-in game. She's at camp. So she told her dad, though, she said, just make it to the playoffs so I can get to the game.
I may have
so
to change DeMar's my pick, though, if she's not there. I may have to change my pick. I do love with the Bulls roster just how much, and again, this is just on a personal note, how much they've leaned into bringing in guys that have ties somehow to the area or fit their culture,
yeah.
their identity.
The
Ayo Dosunmu, of course, being top mm-hmm. among them, the former star at Illinois. Kobe White, I think, has really been embraced by the city of Chicago.
Definitely.
It took a couple of years. So I do like that young backcourt, and I will go with the Bulls for my midday My Bookie picks. And, of course, you can get in on the action at mybookie.ag. Make sure you log in so you're able to see all of the sports betting lines. And don't forget to check out their live casino. You can literally press it. It'll be like a Zoom link. And immediately a live dealer appears on your computer screen, just like you're at a real-life casino, ladies.
There you have it. We have one more comment from Trevor Lawrence. We also have some local sports to update you. We just did Iceman. We've got others. You are listening to Helmets and Heels. One segment to go on 1010XL 92.5 FM.
This is Helmets and Heels.
This hour is brought to you by First Coast Honda Dealers.
Now hear this.
Here's 1010XL's new lineup.
We're going to send you back to the future.
Buckle up.
Dan and Jeff in the morning. Mike and Tony 10 to noon. Mia, Lauren and Taylor noon to 2. Joe, Matt and Leon 2 to 4. Frank and Hayes 4 to 6. And Rick and Hacker in the evening.
We invite you now to listen.
At Honda, we appreciate all the comparisons to other vehicles. And no matter how many times they compare their vehicles to a Honda, only a Honda is a Honda. Remember, value, quality, safety. There is no substitute. Visit your local Honda dealer now and experience the difference.
Hello, First Coast. I'm sure by now you have seen our bright green GFL trucks and containers throughout the greater Jacksonville area. We're an industry leader in solid waste and would love the opportunity to earn your business. We're committed to customer service, reliability, and have an unwavering focus on safety. Whether commercial or construction, let us haul your waste away. Call 904-760-5880 to get a quote today from GFL, Green for Life.
Best Bet is number one. That's right, Best Bet Jacksonville, Orange Park, and St. Augustine have one card poker, the fastest and easiest card game to learn and play. Play one card at a time, and the highest card wins even money. If the card values are the same, it's time for war, just like the game you remember. You must be 18 years or older to play. More at bestbetjacks.com. That's bestbetjacks.com.
David Lane here again for Southeast Orthopedic Specialist. After several surgeries for age-old issues, mainly my back and shoulders, there's no doubt that Southeast Orthopedic Specialist is my sustaining resource for living pain-free. Take it from me, and I'm being really honest here, there's no better orthopedic facility here in Jacksonville.
Relieve pain and get back to life.
SOS.
Southeast Orthopedic Specialist.
Your AC's broke, it ain't no joke. Call Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. Florida Home AC. FloridaHomeAC.com.
1010XL keeps you company with sports takes and local talk.
Well, then that's exactly what we'll do.
Saturday from noon to 2.
Got any ideas who this mystery man might be?
It's Compton and Company.
What if word about this gets out?
On 1010XL, Jacksonville Sports Radio.
Now that's what I call high quality H2O.
If you want high quality water throughout your home, call your local water boy. We install equipment to solve any water problem. Waterboy, J-A-X.
RJ Saunders here, sports lovers. I recently took a tip from Frank Frangie when I needed to send flowers to my mother. Frank told me that Kuhn Flowers is the only florist he ever uses. So that's what I do now. I use Kuhn Flowers. Find them online at kuhnflowers.com.
Prosser here. When it comes to the business of selling your home, there's one promise I can give you that will deliver, and that promise is chadandsandy.com. That's Chad, A-N-D, Sandy.com. How do I know this promise is guaranteed? Because they say so, and then they deliver. You see, Chad and Sandy guarantee your home sold at an agreed-upon price and deadline, or they will buy it. So whatever problems you think you're having selling your home, there is your simple solution. They're going to buy it if it's not sold for exactly what you want. Mortgage rates have lowered going into the spring selling season. Now is the time to maximize your equity, and you can do it with the real estate team of Chad and Sandy. They have a plan and the experience to sell your home fast for maximum cash this spring. John and Ursula in Green Meadows wrote in, we weren't in great health, decided to downsize to an easier place to manage. After 185 days, our home failed to sell. We went to Chad and Sandy, sold in 12 days. You can too at chadandsandy.com.
You're shrimping.
Jumbo Shrimp Baseball, presented by FIS, is home all week at 1-1 Financial Ballpark. Tonight is Vistar Good is Everywhere Wednesday, featuring Habba Jacks. Tomorrow is Coors Light Thirsty Thursday with beer specials. Then it's Red Shirt Friday with fireworks. And the first 2,000 fans on Saturday get Frozen Shrimp hockey jersey, plus more fireworks. Tickets start at just $5. Log on to jackshrimp.com for tickets.
I-9 Sports wants to make sure kids all over the First Coast can enjoy growing up on a field or in a gym. And right now, summer and fall registration is open. So make sure you find out what I-9 Sports offers in your area across Duval, Clay, and St. John's. I9Sports.com. Enter 1010 in the promo code.
What's the penalty in baseball for a fielder throwing his glove at a batted ball in fair territory and hitting it?
When you call Southern Oak and file a claim, you'll be handled by our hand-picked vendors who will analyze any roof, storm, or water damage. It'll save money for you.
Our family protecting yours, Southern Oak Insurance.
If a fielder throws his glove at a batted ball in fair territory and hits it, it's scored a ground rule triple.
Southern Oak Insurance. Our family protecting yours.
Prosser here for Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. With the weather starting to turn for the better, look ahead. Get that backyard ready for spring with a new screened-in enclosure. Maximize the space you have and make it great with Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. They truly are best in the business. If you have the space and the idea, give them a call today. Lifetime Enclosures and Lifetime Flooring. Showroom just off Phillips Highway. Tell them Prosser sent you, proud partner of the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Life isn't the same without live music. Players Grill Mandarin has Samuel Sanders performing covers and original music this Saturday at 8 p.m. Jam out with this local singer-songwriter while enjoying tasty food everyone can enjoy. Players Grill Mandarin, where the neighborhood
meets. 1010XL is presented by Farrah & Farrah, exclusive injury law firm of the Jacksonville Jaguars. Protecting you and your family. Call 396-5555, Jacksonville.
This is Helmets and Heels.
Kept classy by First Coast Lighting and Fans. Upscale lighting, fans, and home decor.
On 1010XL.
You know, well, I'm a chicken fried. A cold beer on a Friday night. A pair of jeans that fit just right. And a radio.
One segment to go here on Helmets and Heels on 1010XL on 2.5 FM. Taylor Dahl, Mia O'Brien, RJ Saunders, I'm Lauren Brooks. By the way, this song was the final segment of the Frangie Show for many, many, many years. This song would enter the very final segment. So it's always Friday at, I forgot to mention that part, Friday at 5:40 p.m. Show ended at 6 p.m. Mm-hmm. Or before that, show would end at 7 p.m. So it was like the 6:40 segment.
So when I hear about to get to the weekend,
well, I was going to say I'm today, about to get to the weekend. However, that is appropriate for Mia.
Right. Today is my Friday. A little vacation of sorts. I promise. I don't think they fired me. A little vacation of sorts.
The code doesn't work when you get
back. Yeah, I won't be surprised.
Blake Bortles had that, famous comment. Hey, if my code still works.
Right. Exactly. A little pre-draft vacay for me. And so because I won't be here tomorrow, I know we have a couple other news and notes we want to get to. But Taylor, I have to get this off my chest.
Okay.
A buddy of mine commented after I shared on Instagram the social media post that's been going viral of Caitlin Clark beat Trevor Lawrence for the most amount of jerseys sold the night they were drafted number one overall. And my friend is a Bears fan, and he lives in Chicago, and he said, it's a great record, because mind you, he's also an Iowa alum. He goes, too bad it's going to be broken in 8 days. By Caleb Williams. And I said, you really think that many Bears fans are going to go flocking to get a specific Caleb jersey? Mm-hmm. And I'm not saying that there's not Bears fans that will, like that they won't. But I think with Trevor, it was like this cultural moment for Jacksonville, who, quite frankly, had never really had that bona fide generational talent. And obviously we know the history of the Chicago Bears quarterback situation, and it's pretty similar to the Jaguars, but at the same time
probably worse.
Right, exactly. But historically speaking, in terms of Chicago having nice things, I understand it was 40-30 years ago, but I was very curious to get your take, because I don't think that they're going to be flying off the shelves quite like Trevor or Caitlin Clark.
Yeah, that actually will be interesting. I know people who have already got their Caleb Williams jerseys in Chicago, so some have a head start on that, but it was such a divided topic. Like, there was not that division in Jacksonville. Like, everyone wanted Trevor Lawrence. There was no question about that. We had already pre-made statues about Trevor Lawrence.
He was unquestionably the number one pick. Like, there was even some smoke about is Caleb even the pick? There was none of that.
And I think that most fans have now skewed to okay, this is happening, let's start getting on board and getting ourselves there. But I do think that a lot of people feel are going to be very cautious this time because of what happened with Justin Fields. And they were all on board with Justin Fields. Everyone loved Justin Fields. And the way that it panned out, I think there may be some hesitation now of are we doing this again? What if this guy busts again, or just doesn't pan out? I don't consider Justin Fields a bust. I just think that things didn't pan out just because of things surrounding him. But it didn't work for the Bears. And so if you have to go through another situation of that, so I do think there'll be some hesitation of people being I'll buy a jersey if he proves it, once we start playing. But I do think there'll probably be a lot. I mean, there's a lot of people in Chicago. There's a lot of Bears fans everywhere around the nation. And there's a lot of people that are very pumped about this pick and truly believe that it is what is going to change the organization as a whole. So it'll be interesting to see those numbers, honestly, how many Bears fans are hesitant and how many Bears fans are all right, here we go. Quarterback numbers 89 in the last 10 years. But hopefully this is it. So we'll see. That's an interesting thing, though.
We will hear Trevor Lawrence's comment on Ryan Nielsen tomorrow, since we ran out of time, but just wanted to update everyone. As far as local sports are concerned, we had that exciting walk-off for the Jumbo Shrimp yesterday. Here's the call from Scott Kornberg.
The 1-1. Line shot deep to right to the corner, and one hops the wall. Myers around third. He comes in to score. Shrimp win. It's a walk-off victory for the first time in 2024. Victor Mesa Jr.'s walk-off single wins it 4-3 in the series opener for Jacksonville.
So, yes, the Jumbo Shrimp home series against Norfolk Tides continues tonight. First pitch 7:05. By the way, the Rays last night also won with a walk-off single. Inning 13. I was up till 10:30 watching this.
Ours went into extras, too.
Yeah, extras are
fine. Two nights straight.
But 13 innings to find a winner, it was against
and
the
runners
Angels.
Start on second.
Correct. They would score. The Angels would score a run, then the Rays would score a run. Then the Angels, then the Rays. Anyway, that's enough complaining out of me. FSU baseball fell to 30-6 on the season, still a terrific record. But they lost to Mercer last night 13-6, very surprising midweek result for FSU. And then when it comes to Florida and JU, Florida improved to 19-7 after beating JU last night 12-1 in seven innings. So then also a surprise victory for Florida midweek, since that doesn't happen very often. Jack Caglione hit his 21st home run, and ladies, it went 516 feet.
Ooh.
And I can tell you, when there is no video of it because the cameras are focused on the field. It went over the scoreboard. Mm-hmm. So when I tried to watch it, the highlight, even though I was trying to watch it live, and then to watch the highlight, there is no highlight because it went over the scoreboard and the cameras were not prepared for that. And after just having been at Condren Ballpark, that scoreboard is huge.
Yeah.
So unbelievable stuff from Cags.
Did you hear Daniel Murphy ragging on Gator baseball a little bit
this
morning?
I did not, but as well he should.
Yeah.
Yeah, the pitching, we will see if that gets better as the back half of the season is underway. All right, that's going to do it for us, for Taylor Dahl, for Mia O'Brien, for RJ Saunders. I'm Lauren Brooks. These heels are made for talking. We will talk to you tomorrow, but of course, don't go anywhere. XL Primetime is next.
Are gonna walk all over you.
Yeah. Mia here for Window Gang. It's spring and time to give your home or business a